afternoon to all of you. I am Vaishnave Deshpande, presenting my PhD pre-submission seminar on performance enhancement of photovoltaic array by maximum power point tracking using array reconfiguration and AI-based method under the guidance of Dr. S.B. Bodke. These are the content of the presentation. First, introduction to the research area, need of research, literature review, research gap identified through literature review, objectives of the research work, partial shading condition, PV array topology, topology overview, maximum power point tracking schemes, study of partial shading effect, shade analysis and discussion, proposed work, comparative analysis of proposed work with existing algorithm, application examples, conclusion, future scope and references. Introduction. Now, solar energy is the most dominant renewable source of energy. This solar energy faces a new challenge, main challenges of maximizing the energy and minimizing the cost of energy generation. Now, due to this, it opens the new research field of maximizing the power or maximum extraction of power from the solar array. So, the main objectives of our research are to maximize the output power of the solar array. At the same time, we have to minimize the cost of generation of energy. Now, solar energy is the most dominant second generation power energy, and that's why this is what the this is our area of research. Now, need of research. Now, PV technology has numerous advantages, numerous ecological advantages, but it faces the major limitations of cost and dependence on the continuously varying weather condition. In the recent few years, the cost of PV cells is continuously decreasing, and from the last 2 years, the cost of PV crystalline PV cell is about $0.3 per watt. And the second major limitation is the dependence on the continuously varying weather condition. Now, conventionally fixed solar arrays are used and mounted, and these arrays are mounted by taking into consideration the irradiance data of throughout the year. And therefore, these arrays get mostly affected by the continuously varying condition, because these arrays don't have the facility to bypass or to compensate the energy losses which occurs in the array due to partial shading. Now, how to avoid is this partial shading is the concept of reconfiguring the PV module arrangement in the solar array itself. So this is what our area of or baseline of our work is. We are going to reconfigure the arrangement of the PV modules in a solar array to extract maximum power from it. Now, the literature review, the detailed literature review given here. First is the adaptive solar photovoltaic array using modeled based reconfiguration algorithm. Now, in this, the author has proposed two sorting algorithm, ascending and descending algorithm, and basically in this paper the array reconfiguration is based on the voltage compensation, whereas voltage is not at all too much affected by the partial shading effect, but current is largely affected. The second is the improved optimization strategy for irradiance equalization in dynamic photovoltaic array. Now, in this the author has proposed a dynamic array reconfiguration, but in this case, as per the different irradiances, the author has proposed different channels of connecting the modules, and therefore this method gives the output in appreciable increment in the output, but the number of channels, number of DC-DC converter continuously goes on increasing. Then, optimal photovoltaic array reconfiguration to reduce partial shading effect. Now, in this also a mixed integer quadratic formula is used, but whatever the algorithms are used in these three proposed works, all the algorithm has a basic drawback that as the array size go on increasing, the complexity of the algorithm go on increasing. Then, in 2013, Romano et al. Optimization of photovoltaic energy production through an efficient switching matrix. In this work also, two optimization algorithms are suggested. the two optimization algorithm gives the increment in the energy, but again these algorithm continuously rotates towards the local maximas and become and in complexity increases as the size of array increases. Then is the Sudoku arrangement proposed in position of PV modules for reduction in line losses and mismatch losses. Now Sudoku arrangement gives the solves the problem of local maxima, but in Sudoku the all the PV modules are physically relocated, due to which the lengthy connecting wires are required and a tedious physical work is required in the Sudoku arrangement. Then again in the photovoltaic array reconfiguration strategy for maximization of energy production, in this method also dynamic programming is done with the help of rough set theory, and the last dynamic programming and Mukri algorithm for optimum photovoltaic array reconfiguration. In this research work again the subset knapsack problem algorithm is used to find out the optimum configuration of the solar array. In addition to that, the MA, that is Mukri's assignment algorithm, is used for balancing the switching operations. Now these are our baseline papers: the optimized string dynamic photovoltaic array, improved optimization strategy for irradiance equalization in dynamic photovoltaic array, and optimal photovoltaic array reconfiguration to reduce the partial shedding losses. Research gap identified through the literature review. Now whatever the literature review we have carried out, the few research gaps which the author has identified are the most of the algorithms are complex, time consuming algorithm, as well as physical rearrangement of the module is required. Similarly, very less work is published on the optimization technique. Most of the algorithm and sorting algorithms used for the array reconfiguration basically focus on irradiance equalization without accounting for the increased in hardware, as well as complexity of the algorithm and time consumption. And also the shade analysis part is in very few papers shade analysis is carried out, so that it will help to find out which type of shade is mostly affecting the solar array, so that we can do the remedial measure on that. Now these are the research objectives. After the literature research gap identified, the whatever the work we are going to carry out in our research, we have divided it into the research objectives. First, to study and estimate the output power profile of PV system using MATLAB simulation tool at different irradiances. At the same time, we have to study the different topologies considering this PV profile. Then to apply the statistical analysis is the shade analysis we have done here. The shade analysis we have carried out to find out the mismatching losses or the output power we got from different topologies, so that we can identify which is the topology we can further use for applying the optimization concept. Then MPPT control technique based on array reconfiguration we have used. And then last objective is to explore the possibility of AI and using adaptive reconfiguration system using this optimization technique. Now partial shading occurs in the PV module when they are directly screened from the sunlight. Now when the solar cell doesn't receive the solar energy, it will act as a load and it absorbs the energy and causes the hotspot problem. Now in case of series connected solar cell, all the series connected solar cells work on the shortest link phenomenon. If one of the module get affected or faulty, the overall current of the link get reduced. Therefore it is essential to work on the area of partial shedding. Now up till now bypass diodes are used to avoid the partial shedding problem, Decentralized MPPT techniques are used, and third is the adaptive PV reconfiguration using bypass diode. Now, bypass diodes are used to avoid the partial shedding. These bypass diodes are connected across each and every faulty module. Therefore, connecting a bypass diode is itself adding losses of bypass diode in the solar array. Therefore, this technique at a large scale, this technique is not does not give appreciable result. Decentralized MPPT, in case of decentralized MPPT, each PV module is associated with its DC-DC converter provided with MPPT technology. But due to this, the cost of DC-DC converter goes increasing. At the same time, the MPPT controller cost also increases. Then the last, third one is the adaptive PV reconfiguration. Now, in adaptive PV reconfiguration, whatever the solar array provided with us, we are going to change the placement or the locations of the solar modules such that whatever the shade appear on the solar panel, we can reduce the effect of that shade. So, we are focusing on adaptive PV array reconfiguration here. The basic concepts of solar array and solar cells are given. A single solar cell when combined together to give a module, and when these modules are combined together, it will give us an array. Now, different array topologies are used. As per the literature review or existing study, it is proved that array topology itself affect the maximum power. Means, using the different topologies also, we can extract the maximum power from the solar array. Therefore, this topology study also plays very important role. Different topologies are series array, parallel array. Series parallel is the combination of series connected strings in parallel. Total cross tied is parallel connected solar cells connected in string. Then bridge link and honeycomb. These are the various topologies. Now, our first objective is to find out the topology which will form our base to proceed. Therefore, firstly, we have prepared a 6x6 PV array. Now, this 6x6 PV array, with these specifications we have modeled in MATLAB. This 6x6 PV array we have simulated in MATLAB, and we have tabulated or we have observed the PV characteristics of each and every topology at varying irradiance condition. Because every time partial shading doesn't occur, varying irradiance also plays an important role. Therefore, firstly we have carried out varying irradiance test on these topologies. Now these are the results. From these results we come to know that all the topologies behave approximately similar in case of varying irradiance condition. In that case, the partial shading condition plays important role in deciding the topology. So we have done the partial shading condition. Now, partial shading condition is done considering few standard test shade conditions, because no as such benchmarks are there for the partial shade. So standard test shade conditions are considered. So first is the uniform. In all the PV modules are irradiated uniformly, giving the output diagonal shade. Then long narrow, short narrow, long wide and short wide. These conditions, these shaded conditions are designed on the solar array using shade factors, shading factors, and using shading factors, these all the shades are designed on the solar array, and we have done the analysis of all the topologies. And from these topologies, topology results, we come to the conclusion that TCT, that is total cross-tied combination topology, is least affected by most of the shade conditions. Now, this also in TCT topology, because of its constructional structure, it has the advantage that it requires minimum number of bypass diode. If we consider, means in the result, that we can observe that BL and HC, both the topologies have similar, approximately similar result with TCT, but in case of BL and HC, to every faulty module bypass diode is required. In case of total cross tied, eliminates the need of very high number of bypass diodes. Similarly, reliability analysis. This reliability analysis we have referred from the literature review. They have done this with the cut set theory, and this theory tells that by insertion of more and more parallel ties, the stress on the topology reduces, the voltage and stress. When the shade falls on the solar array, the voltage and current stresses makes the array weak or makes the connection weak, and this reliability analysis proves that as the number of ties in total cross-tied connections are more, it is more reliable under partial shedding condition. Also, the cost analysis we have referred, the cost analysis also it proves that even though TCT has more number of ties, the cost analysis proves that in mass production, the costing of all the topologies are approximately similar. Therefore, as per this literature review and whatever the simulation results we got, we come to the stand that the further investigation, the base of our work is total cross-tied topology. Now, introduction to maximum power point tracking. Now, what exactly is maximum power point tracking? Maximum power point tracking, in shortly we can say it is a maximum power transfer theorem, means matching the impedance of load with the source so that we can transfer the maximum energy. Now, in case of maximum power point tracking, DC to DC generators, converters are used to increase the voltage or current in steps so that we can achieve. These are the trial and error processes. We can increase the voltage in some step, voltage increment, current increment to achieve the maximum power point. Now, this maximum power point tracking techniques has the basic drawback that they always confused at the local maxima. Once they achieve the maxima, it will never try to get the global maxima, and in order to get the global maxima, additional hardware as well as complexity in the algorithm is required. And that's why from all the maximum power point tracking, we have focused on array reconfiguration to work on. So now, in order to study the array reconfiguration study, firstly we have analyzed the TCT topology in detail, so that in order to understand which type of shade affect our topology the most, so that we can find out the remedial measure. So a CTI 95 commercial module here we have used to form an array. These are the various test conditions or test we have performed on the total cross-tied connected PV array. A 5 into 5 total cross-tied connected array we have used here. Simulation at varying irradiance, then simulation at percent shade condition. Now, this percent shade condition we have considered because it is a combination of row and column shade to observe the result. Then simulation at row shade, simulation at column shade, and then the different standard test condition we have observed for total cross-tied connection. Now, this is the simulated model. Now, at varying irradiance test, we have simulated the array at 1800, 600 in the steps of 200 to observe its output. Then the percent shade condition we have done. In the percent, 25%, 75%, 50% modules we have shaded. We have designed the shade. Again, shade is designed using the shade factor. These are the results we got for 25%, 75% and 50% shading. Then column shading we have done on the same 5 into 5 TCT configured PV array. And these are the output we got for single column shading, 2 column shading, 3 column shading and 4 column shading. The similar analysis done for row shading analysis. Single row, 2 row, 3 row, and the results are given. Now we can also observe that due to this type of shading, the characteristics what we got from the PV array, it also got affected, and we got multiple peaks in the PV curve. These multiple peaks are also the cause of confusion in the local and global maxima. Therefore, this PV smoothness or smoothening of this PV array characteristics is also one of our lookout in our research area. Now these are the standard condition: long narrow shade, long wide shade, short narrow shade, short wide shade, diagonal shade, and random shade. These shades are simulated and designed on the solar arrays, and these are the result we got for diagonal, random, short narrow, long narrow, short wide, and long wide shade. The shade analysis here we have done, that column shade results are given with the row shade, and we can observe that the TCT configuration got more affected by row shading. Similarly, what the conclusion we got here, we have again cleared it from the analysis at standard test condition. We got the same result from this test condition also. The shades which are wide, which included the row, are more affect the array, and therefore from this analysis we come to the conclusion that if on the TCT topology, if the row shades are converted to column, then the array will give the maximum, means the shade can be disappeared and maximum power can be drawn from the total cross-tied configuration. And up till now, whatever the technology is present here, or we observed in the literature review, all the technology basically focuses on equalizing the irradiance. In this work, we have concentrated on irradiance equalization as well as minimization of switching count. Now, in this work, switching count means the movement of the module. Position changing of the module is referred as switching. Now, artificial intelligence is nothing but the process of reducing the repetitive work using the computer programming. Now, this artificial intelligence we have combined with the optimization. Now, optimization gives the two basic approaches of heuristic and meta-heuristic. Now, these are the optimization problem classification we have given. Now, selection of heuristic. Now, when we identified the problem, in TCT topology, we want to reduce the shade by converting it to column pattern. At the same time, we have two objectives to work on. First is we are going to equalize the irradiance of the row. And secondly, we require the heuristic, or we require the optimization which has a memory-based approach, so that previously based experiences it must retain. And we want a constructive algorithm so that step by step our shade get disappear. And as per this requirement, we focuses on ant colony optimization to obtain the optimal PV array configuration. Now, the ant colony optimization is totally based upon the natural behavior of ant. That ant has the tendency to always find the shortest path from nest to food. Now, ant colony optimization, for explaining ant colony optimization, an obstacle is introduced in the path. Now, as the obstacle is inserted, at that point the ant get distributed in the two paths. Few ant follow the longest path and few follow the shortest path. Now, during the transition of ant, they continuously emit the chemical substance called pheromone, and this pheromone help another ant to follow the same route. Now, the velocity of movement of ant is the same, therefore the ant which has longest path will reach the destination. The ant which follows the shorter path will reach the destination first, and thus movement or the deposition of pheromone on that path will be more, and shortest path can be identified. Now, how to apply this ant colony optimization to our PV array reconfiguration? And for that, this exam, for this diagram is given. Now, a depot is considered outside the PV array. A 3x3 PV array we have assumed here. A depot, and on that depot the ant are resting, or that is the initial position of the ant. Now ant will move, or ant will prefer its path as per the objectives and as per the constraint we have specified. Ant transition and transit to the module as per the probabilistic or pseudo random proportionality formula which is given here. Now this is the ant colony optimization proportionality rule. It is based upon the local pheromone, or the pheromone deposited on the path, as well as the heuristic information we fed to the probability. Now heuristic information is nothing but the problem information. In our case, heuristic information, we have two heuristics used. First one is the irradiance, and second one is switching. Now as the ant proceed from one module, the local pheromone get modified, and as the ant complete its path, the global pheromone get updated. Now the problem presentation. This ant colony optimization approach we have considered with our 5x5 TCT topology. Now this topology is considered as the combination of 5 tires connected in string. Therefore, the first tire connected in series with second. Therefore, in order to maximize the current flowing through the TCT topology, the tires which are given, we have to equalize the impedance of the tires so that maximum current will be flown from the string. Now for this we have considered the PV array with n number of n into m number of modules, that is the total number of modules. Now here first the total irradiance is calculated using the formula, and average irradiance is calculated. Now our first objective is EI, that is S average minus SI, where S average is the average of total irradiance and SI is the irradiance of one tier. Average, from the average we have to minimize this difference so that each and irradiance of each and every tier will be equal, and maximum current will be available from the string. The second objective is of course the minimizing the switching operation. Now from the initial solution to final solution, now the mathematical formulation of the objectives we have done. From the mathematical object formulation, the first objective is psi 1, that is here S average minus summation of j equal to 1 to m, I equal to 1 to n, Sij, and it is multiplied with Xij, that is the imaginary link present, and the value of the imaginary link will be 1 if the module is visited. It is 0 if the module is not unvisited. This is the second objective functions. This objective function is also associated with the imaginary link. Now these two objectives are satisfied with the constraint, or subject to this constraint. Now all the analysis we have done considering a uniform PV array, because if we consider the non-uniform array, the ant transition, it will be difficult for ant transition. So first constraint is that whatever the number of modules present in a tier must be equal to under root of m total, that is solar array must be symmetrical. Second objective is every module must be visited once, and that's why it is assigned 1. Each link becomes 0 if module is visited, that is the case of Xij, and Swij I star j star will be equal to 1 only if I is equals to I star. Means if the module got shifted from in the same tier, if the module shifted in the same tier, the switching count will be 1, otherwise it will be 2. Now the validation of the proposed algorithm, we have considered the same shedding conditions using the 5x5 TCT topology, and here we got the result with our proposed ant colony system for column shedding, row shedding, standard test condition.